Good morning and welcome to the sixth meeting of Session 6 of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee. We have apologies from Graeme Simpson, MSP, so can I welcome back Maurice Golden, MSP, as a committee substitute. And before we move to the first item on the agenda, I'd like to remind everyone present to switch their mobile phones to silent. The first item of business is to decide whether to take items 6 and 7 in private. Is the committee content to take these items in private? Under agenda item number 2, we're considering instruments subject to the made affirmative procedure. An issue has been raised on one of these instruments, which is SSI 2022-40, the Coronavirus Act 2020, alteration of expiry date, Scotland Regulations 2022. The instrument extends the expiry date of various provisions of the 2020 Act that apply in Scotland from the 24th of March 2022 to the 24th of September 2022. In correspondence with the Scottish Government, the committee asked two questions related to this instrument. Firstly, clarification was sought on the statement in the accompanying policy note that only the made affirmative procedure was available for this instrument. And secondly, the committee sought clarification on the extension of the expiry by Regulation 2A of the instrument of Section 18.2 and Part 2 of Schedule 13 of the 2020 Act. In response, the Scottish Government firstly confirmed that Section 95.5 of the Coronavirus Act 2020 does give a choice of procedure between affirmative and made affirmative procedures. Secondly, the Scottish Government acknowledged that Regulation 2A, read on its own, implies that the transitional provisions in paragraphs 15 and 16 of Schedule 13 and Section 18.2 and paragraph 10 of that schedule, so far as relating to those paragraphs 15 and 16 are also extended to the 24th of September 2022. However, the leading text to Regulation 2 makes clear explicitly that the instrument, and so Regulation 2A, only extends the relevant provisions, quote, when they would otherwise expire by virtue of Section 89 of the Act, close quote. The Scottish Government thanked the committee for drawing this matter to its attention. It has since laid an amending policy note to clarify that a choice of procedure is available and to add an explanation of the combined effect of Regulation 2A of the instrument and Section 89.2S of the Coronavirus Act 2020. Do members have any comments to make on this instrument? Mr. Hoy.
Thank you, Convener. Just to put on the record some concerns that I have about the instrument, and perhaps to make a suggestion as to how we might satisfactorily address those concerns. From a general point of view, I have a concern about the extension of these powers at this time, given that we are emerging from the COVID pandemic, and these are emergency powers that it could be perceived are now being used or extended into a non-emergency period. And I note that a number of these provisions come into effect from March the 24th to September the 24th, and that given the opportunity to use either the affirmative or the made affirmative instrument, after the government clarified that both routes were open to them, they still determined to use the made affirmative instrument, which does limit the scrutiny of this Parliament in relation to the measures contained within the instrument. So if it is acceptable to the committee, what I would like to propose is that we hold off on this and try and delay further consideration of this and write to the relevant minister, the Deputy First Minister, to see if we might be able to bring forward an evidence session with him so that we can put these concerns to him and seek any subsequent reassurance in relation both to the provision of the measures that will be extended and also in relation to the use of the made affirmative for this particular instrument.
OK, thank you, Mr. Hoy. Any other comments, colleagues? No? OK. So with that, then, I know we do have some time, a short space of time, and I'd be content for the committee to write as suggested, and then also can take the matter from there, if that's OK with everyone. OK. So, also under this agenda item, no points have been raised on SSIs 2022, 46 and 53. Do any members have any comments to make on either of these instruments? No. So, that is the committee content with these two instruments. Yeah. Under agenda item number 3, we're considering instruments subject to the affirmative procedure. No points have been raised on the following draft instruments: the Forensic Medical Services Self-Referral Evidence Retention Period, Scotland Regulations 2022, the Forensic Medical Services Modification of Functions of Healthcare Improvement Scotland and Supplementary Provision Regulations 2022, the Budget Scotland Act 2021 Amendment Regulations 2022, the Health Protection Coronavirus Requirements Scotland Amendment Number 4 Regulations 2022, and the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions Directions by Local Authorities Scotland Amendment Regulations 2022. Do any members have any comments to make on any of these instruments? Mr Hoy.
Thank you, Convener. If I could come in on Health Protection Coronavirus Requirements Scotland Amendment Number 4 Regulations, and effectively just to flag up this as an instrument of concern, which, if approved, would come into effect on February the 27th, which is only a matter of days away. So I'm concerned, obviously, about the expedited nature of this. I accept it is an affirmative instrument, so we will get a vote on it. But the measures contained within this instrument are really quite fundamental, and they do include the ongoing wearing of face coverings and the use of vaccine passports, which I understand have been, certainly the latter, has been an issue that this committee has taken quite considerable interest in. Given that we are no longer in an emergency situation, I find it hard to see the justification for gifting these powers to the government any longer. And I think, I know we're having a debate on the use of delegated legislation this afternoon, I don't want to rehearse the arguments in relation to that, but I think given that we don't have much time to scrutinise this, and I think the lead committee has also expressed reservations about the window of opportunity to examine these regulations and the extension of these regulations, and given that I can't see the justification either for the regulations or in fact for using a delegated route to extend them, especially given that there is primary legislation coming forward that will look at these issues that we'll discuss in private later and the Parliament will be debating in the future. So on this basis, I wouldn't be content for us not to draw the attention of Parliament to this instrument, and therefore I would seek to have a vote on this particular instrument.
Okay, thank you. Any other colleagues? Any comments? No. Okay, well, certainly, I think you've raised a number of points there, Mr Hoy. I think some of your concerns relate to the actual policy issues as compared to, in addition to the actual the route that the instrument has been brought forward into the Parliament. Clearly, in terms of the policy matters, they would be up to have post questions to the relevant Deputy First Minister. In the relevant committee. In terms of the actual order, I know this was a matter that came up in the committee before we knocked off for the recess. I noticed that there were two options for the instrument to come in and, as I made, affirmative or the expedited affirmative process, which I agreed to do so that there could be some dialogue with the committee on and for us to undertake our role better. So with that, I'm content actually with the instrument because of the opportunity that we've actually had to discuss it, and there are the recommended action is to not to draw it to the attention of the Parliament. So I clearly think that there will be a division on this, and if colleagues have got any other comments to make, I'm happy to hear them. No, okay. So it does appear as if that we will have a division on this instrument. So I'll ask members to raise their hands whether they wish to make no recommendations in relation to the instrument. The three options are to agree, to not agree, or to abstain. So could all members who agree please raise your hands. Okay, that's three. Could all members who do not agree please raise your hands. Two. And no members wish to abstain in this. So the committee is therefore agreed. However, members' concerns about the instrument have been expressed and noted on the record. So, and the vote was 3-2. Are there any other comments on any of the other instruments? Mr. Hoyt?
It was just in relation to the health regulations, coronavirus restrictions, directions by local authorities, Scotland Movement Regulations 2022. Just in light of the discussion we had around the extension of expiry date, I just wonder whether or not it might be an opportunity for us to give a further discussion and further scrutiny if indeed we have the Minister in next week.
If we are going to be contacting, and we are going to be contacting the DFM on this, so we can highlight this particular instrument at a conference.
Appreciate that, thank you.
Okay, no problem. Any other comments about the instruments? No, okay. So, is the committee content with these instruments, notwithstanding the vote we just had and the other instrument there from Mr. Hoy? Okay, thank you. Under agenda item number 4, we're considering instruments subject to the negative procedure. No points have been raised on SSIs 2022, 31, 36, 37, 39, 42, 45, 48, 50 and 51. Do members have any comments to make on any of these instruments? Okay. So is the committee therefore content with these instruments? Thank you. Under agenda item number 5, we're considering instruments subject to the laid only procedure. No points have been raised on SSIs 2022, 22, 24 and 43. Is the committee content with these instruments? Okay. Thank you. And with that, I'll move the committee into private.